Previously, we looked at the iron triangle. Today, I plan to move on to a new subject, and then in came a question that really got me scratching my head. Welcome to Development That Pays. My name is Gary Strawn, and this is the question that's tortured me over the last couple of days. In essence, the question is, if you want to have it good and cheap, how does making the project longer help? RaxDaMan, thank you so much for your question. Here's the clip that I think you are referring to. I can do fast, good, and cheap. Which two would you like? Cheap and fast, rush the job and the quality will suffer. Cheap and good is likely to take more time. Fast and good, which might mean putting more people on the job, will push the price up. So we've just seen three pairs of constraints. And I have to say that while I was putting together last week's episode, it was this one that didn't really sit right with me. Because more time means more cost, right? My first thought was to blame the model. Cost and time aren't independent, and we're used to seeing models where parameters are independent. But then I realized that the iron triangle is composed entirely of parameters that are very interdependent. It's kind of the whole point of the model. If I can't blame the model, then one thing I better do is make sure that I'm interpreting it correctly. Let's go through it again. You can fix one parameter, you can fix a second parameter, but you can't fix the third. What we're really saying is that the third one must be allowed to change. Last time I strongly implied the direction of the change, but change in the opposite direction is also possible. We'll see an example of that in a minute. For my next trick, I'm going to bring back the decorator and introduce a client. During their discussions, the decorator and the client have come to a shared expectation about the quality and the scope of the project. For both parties, quality and scope is fixed. They also agree that the project will be done on a fixed price basis. Now, does this mean that cost is fixed? Well, it does mean that the client's cost is fixed. What about the decorator's costs? Well, one way or another, the decorator has estimated that he can do the job for a certain amount of money. The estimate is likely to be based largely on how long he thinks it will take to do the job. So let's say that he thinks it will take him a week, 5 days, and he's priced the job accordingly. Assuming the decorator is a sole trader, there are three possible outcomes. Number one, he completes the job in 5 days as expected. Number two, he completes the job more quickly, let's say 4 days. And three, he gets into trouble along the way and the job takes him longer, let's say 7 days. In each case, his costs are different. I think it's true to say that from his point of view, from the decorator's point of view, it's the quality, the scope, that's fixed. And that's the only parameter that is truly fixed. Each of the three cases we just looked at comes with a different cost and a different time. But in terms of what he delivered, what the client experienced, two parameters were constant in every case, quality slash scope and cost. One project, two people, each with a different view of the iron triangle. The iron triangle is just one element of the Waterfall versus Agile cheat sheet. If you're yet to grab a copy, you'll find a link somewhere around this video. Click the link, follow the instructions, and it's all yours. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please give it a thumbs up. Share it with your network and click the logo for a brand new episode every Wednesday. I look forward to seeing you next time. Cheers for now.